Yeah, I would like to welcome you to our weekly webinar. Trading setups for volatile financial products is our topic today. And like normal at the beginning, here you see the risk disclaimer that these are not trading recommendations or advices. As everyone knows maybe from their past, my name is Christian Walter. I studied mathematics I'm doing the TradeStation support in Germany since 2004. And mainly I'm a coach for stock and option trading. So just a few key facts to me. Today we want to start with the following topics. I think everyone might know the volatility index VIX. And as well the ETF on the volatility index VIX, what is called VXX. It's an ETN. Then the third topic will be options, also like our risk reward ratio or chance risk ratio also called, and as well as examples for the current markets. We have a few examples from yesterday. We can also double check what is available from the situation what we have today in the market, and also how you can link this maybe to your current stock portfolio with some examples what might be interesting for an existing stock portfolio. First of all, we will see this here in our PowerPoint presentation before we later go to the TWS and TradeStation to show you some details, especially for the last two topics. I would like to present a few things here in Trader Workstation and TradeStation. And also feel free if there's any question. We will have the time at the end of our webinar to discuss a few things. You can use the chat function on your right and also send any comment during the presentation. But as I mentioned at the end, we will have at least 10 to 15 minutes to discuss if there's anything what you might know. Yeah, the volatility index VIX we have on the right-hand side. Maybe this is the first important thing. If you see it here, this will be always the highest price or the highest notification what we had in the current not in the current but in the years you see here, and also the lowest. And later on we will see how is the situation in 2020. Because we have seen already like prices what we had in 2008, for example. You see 2018, we also had like here something what was almost up to 50. The highest what we had in the last month was middle of March, above 80. And yeah, you can see also years with really, really low volatility, what is in 2017. But let's come back to the definition of the volatility index. At the end, it shows you the range where the S&P 500 or how volatile the stocks of the S&P 500 are at the moment. If we really go deeply in the definition itself, it shows the implied volatility, what you see here, of all option prices. All option prices of the S&P 500 over the last 30 days. So, I mean, for anything what you need to know, it's just giving you an example how volatile all the stocks, because the implied volatility of an option is at the end the same what we will see here in expected fluctuation range of the S&P 500. But if you go closer and deeper and more detailed in the definition, it will always guide you to the implied volatility of options of the 30 days in percentage points. So the ETF, I know maybe some of you attended our last webinar last week, where we discussed a few things about ETFs, especially here for European Union citizens, where this ETF, for example, is also not tradable, not for everyone. I gave a few examples how you still can trade this, and later on we will also discuss a few things here, how it's possible to be part of this. It's the largest and most liquid ETN for volatility. There are a few others also for other indices as well, like DAX, but the S&P 500 volatility ETN is the largest, and you will see it. There are the most options traded, and it's really the most liquid thing what you can trade at any market regarding volatility. It's calculated from the future, from the VIX future, what we've seen earlier. I think the formula and how it's exactly defined, it's nothing what you need to memorize. It's just important that in a long-term trend, you will always see it's going down. At the moment, of course, we have a really high market, the high price for this ETN. But if you look into it for like a long term of period, what we can always say for sure, volatility and normally if it's going up, it will always go down, and it will reach a certain level, what we will see later in the future on the index VIX itself. It's just important to know a few facts, how we can participate from these two things, and how you can maybe use this for your trading setups, or you can also use it, what is very common, to protect maybe your stock portfolio against situations what we had now in March, what we still have at the end, because the volatility will stay high, I think, before it really goes back to a level what we had maybe in 2019. This will definitely take a few more months. It will not go down so fast to a level what you've seen maybe in the past. Yeah, how can you participate with options, for example, of this high volatility environment where we are at the moment, almost at every stock market? There are a few option strategies where you can participate of a high volatility regime, what we seen in the market at the moment. For example, short put or put writing, you will also seen in a few descriptions. Because an option is always calculated from time and inner value, and also the implied volatility. And as the implied volatility is very high at the moment, and you might buy an option, you will always pay a higher price than maybe 4 or 5 months ago. So to make a use of this high price, you always I don't want to say are better when you are selling options, but especially if you want to invest in certain stocks at the moment and you don't know is it already cheap or will it maybe go down a little bit more, then short put or put writing is really something what will give you the benefit of the high implied volatility and maybe also a lower price where you can enter this stock, for example. And the same after you have this stock or the stock is in your portfolio, you can have a covered call. It's the same principle. You just sell a call option on an existing stock. It's always important here that one option, maybe I will put it below. One option is equal 100 stocks. So it's just working if you really want to buy minimum 100 stocks. Same if for the covered call, you must have at least 100 stocks in your portfolio or 100 shares that you can open a covered call. Otherwise, for lower amounts, it's not possible to use options in connection of your stock portfolio. With the short put, if someone already is having some knowledge about options, it's always like you choose a strike price. For example, you want to buy, yeah, we can later make an example if you go back to the TWS, but to come back to this two credit call and credit put spreads to option strategies here. These are, I think, very important at the current situation, what we see now at the market, because it always gives you like something what you really need at the moment at the market, fixed calculated chance risk ratio, because credit call means always you have like a long and a short call, or a long and a short put, if you go back to credit put spread. And this is like something what is important, because you know your maximum risk and you know your maximum chance at the beginning. And also here I will give you later some example what makes this maybe a little bit clearer and easier to understand, because we might not know how deep a stock can fall at the moment. And if you want to buy it for let's say $20 and it's going down to 10, you should always have like yeah, some airbag, some safety, I will call it like this. And this will be provided by credit call or credit put spreads, where you can define exactly at the beginning what's maximum risk, maximum chance, and makes it very easy to calculate how much or how big you can open this position related to your risk. Short strangle, short straddle is something I also added here for a few things. We can also add this if you're like having some more knowledge in option trading, but I don't want to recommend to any beginner to work with like a short strangle or short straddle. It's at the end selling a call and a put option at the same time, straddle with the same strike price, strangle with some different strike prices. But for some indices, it might also work, because indices, we know there's no earnings, not that big gap normally what we've seen in yeah, single stocks. But also here we will have some examples later how you can use options. I think I mentioned a few ideas already in the last seminars for the ETF and how to create a stock portfolio, which you can also see on our YouTube channel. So there will be more examples later after this presentation. Yeah, risk reward ratio or chance risk, it's like credit spreads. For example, we will only open them with a maximum risk reward ratio with 1 to 4. It's just easy. If you want to earn like $1, you just have to risk maximum 4. This maybe sounds for someone who's not familiar with options quite high. I will explain it later, because you have a very high probability with option selling that you gain the maximum profit. And this is like 78% of all options normally expires without any value. And this is something, this probability, we will need this to create our credit spreads. Or as we know this, we know we will have like 78% winning trades, and then we can use this ratio, because at the end, if you know there will be only maximum 20% of our spreads which will be not a winning trade from the probability, we can use this chance this risk reward ratio to have like a positive performance at the end. And also for entering the market, like I said in the beginning, there should you can use short puts with exit scenario if the strike price is reached. On the other hand side, also if you want to buy the stock, you can just yeah, leave it like it is without closing it, and if the price goes below your strike price, what I will also give you an example later, you will just have the share in your position, the stock in your position and your portfolio, sorry, and then in the next step, you can have it with a covered call, for example. Very important, maybe I should highlight this, no short calls. To give you an example why this is the highest risk in option trading, let's say you buy AMD and you sell a call option, and AMD is, I think now at the moment, I don't know, $30 or $40, and overnight there will be announcement that AMD is going together with another company, and their price will jump up to 80. Then you're not covered, you can't do anything, and at the end you will have a really big loss. Also, I've seen this in the past with some biotech stocks, and this will really kill your portfolio. And it's the thing what you always have to avoid at the beginning if you start to trade in options. Same with strangle and straddle strategies. I would recommend this in the beginning only on index ETFs, what not so volatile, on maybe not having this big overnight gaps, what is also very important. And just to remember, for every stock portfolio, I will also give you an example later, to have like a really safe stop order. Let's say you buy like Microsoft at, I think at the moment we are around $170, and you want to put a stop order for 160. And I don't know, something happened overnight and the market opens next day 150, 140, then your stop order will only be executed at the price where the market opens. But you can use options, it's very important to have really a safe stop, what will be executed, even if there's a gap. You have to pay a little premium for this, but especially in this time, also on a stock portfolio, to have like really safe stop orders, what will be executed, no matter the what the market will give you. It's another really powerful instrument to lower your risk and to have like a maximum risk what you can calculate at the beginning. These are things which we will all soon see very soon in TWS and TradeStation, where I give you a few examples for everything what we showed here in the presentation. And also here, what we have some examples from yesterday. I will go over all these four symbols. You will see this later also on the TWS. So I think we can just go faster to the next slide so that we will have more time to do this all in the live market situation at the moment. So the last topic what we had on the presentation is how to link it to current stock portfolio. I think I mentioned it already twice. Existing share positions over 100 shares, you can add covered calls. I will also give you an example for this. And if you want to buy, for example, more stocks for an existing position or for like new position, you can also do this with short put options and also like with combining both of them. So just a second. Here we go. I hope you can see all the chart in the TWS of American Airlines. As you all might see here, we have like prices. The lowest price was beginning of April here, above $9. Now we are here at the $11.03. This is the price for the American Airlines stock listed in the S&P 500. Sorry, also in the Nasdaq, I think. But to come back to what we had in our presentation, and we will also go later to the ETF and to the VIX index as well. What we had in our presentation, how can you participate with a short put option, for example? Let's make an example. You want to buy American Airlines for $10. You can place just this normal limit order, and you can wait if this $10 will be reached in the next days, and then your limit order will be filled so that you will have this position in your portfolio. And on the same way, we can do this with an option and to check what we will gain, for example, if we do this instead of just placing a limit order, is very interesting at the moment. And that's exactly what's the topic of the webinar, how you can participate of this high volatility environment what we have at the moment. And I think this example will exactly show you what's the big benefit, what we normally don't have in other situations. We said we want to buy it for $10. You always see on your right hand side all put options should be in any trading app the same. Right is put and left we see call options. And here you have a bid and ask price so that you can exactly see for which price you can buy and sell it. And if we want to buy now, for example, if we want to sell this put option, we get $1.03. Maybe if you place it in the middle of bid and ask, $1.04, $1.05, see it's also moving a little bit. So this is on 24 days, so less than 1 month. It's more than 10% revenues or 10% premium what you get of the entry price of this stock. So the stock you want to buy for $10 and you gain like $1.02 or $0.03, and this is more than 10% of what you have, for example, as a value for the stock. And you see, if you just place a limit order, you will also get this stock for $10. But if you do it through an option, you can even gain a little bit more. You just have to be sure if it's going deeper than this, you will be always executed to the strike price what you choose in the beginning. So for example, if it's going down to 9, your stock position will be executed to 10. But this premium, no matter what will happen, will be always be in your cash balance. So even if it's not going below 10, you will always keep this $1 and 3 or 4 cents per share. And this in any situation, if it's going below, if it's staying higher, just if it's staying above this $10, you will not get this stock. This is the big difference. But otherwise, it's really a big benefit if you want to have a position at the moment to do it with a short put option. Just always remember, it's very important that you I want to buy a minimum 100 shares. If you just want to buy 5 or 10, then you should not do it in option because it's not possible here. Okay, sorry. And the same what we had was for covered call, for example. Let's go back to the covered call. Let's say we already have American Airlines in our portfolio, and we bought it maybe for $11 now, or I don't know, at the end it doesn't matter for which price you will buy it. But if you are having an existing position, it shows some more prices, and we want to sell it, for example, for $13. This is see on the left hand side, $13. We go to call options, and now you can see $13, you get 75 cents per share. So for 100 stocks, it's $75 for 24 days. And also, you have to calculate this again. How much is this in percentage on the value what you are having at the moment? So if we go to the calculator, and we say we bought American Airlines for $11. We just take this 75 cents divided by 11, and it's 6.8% in 24 days. 6.8% premium, what you get on top of your stock position. And if you really have like a dividend share, what's like giving you 5 or 6% dividends every year, on top of this, you can earn a lot with revenues with premium from options. So for existing stocks, if you write a call option, what can happen if it goes above $13? Then you have to sell it for the strike price, what you set here. But also make sure you always have the ability to roll an option. So if you see, okay, $13 might be reached, I can go in the next month to June, July, and choose a higher strike price, because time gives you always higher revenues, higher premium. So it's really important to know the right situation when to roll an option, because then it's a great time at the moment to get like premiums from stock options. And this is what people do with existing stock portfolio if they still have these stocks, even they lost maybe a lot. Or they have a big open loss for existing positions. This is the time where they really earn great premiums with call options on existing stocks, or if they want to buy some more shares with a premium on short puts or put writing. And you can see it in percentage. We didn't even choose 1 month, and we are talking here 7.5 as sorry 6.8% or like 10% if you go to the downside. So this is a really great time to get big premiums from options. And if you have a small portfolio, just to give you another example, and you might say, okay, yeah, with $10, I don't know if I want to really get 100 shares of American Airlines, because nobody knows if it's going down to 8, 6. I don't know. The future will show it. But you can also play it in a little bit different way. And it's exactly what was showing in the presentation with credit spreads. Credit spreads means the same what we had. We can sell a put option. We get now here $1.06, $1.07. You see it's always changing a bit. And to make it a little bit more secured, we will buy a put option for 9. So what can happen if the price really drops that much that it goes to 7, 6? We will not get this share or this stock, American Airlines, for 10, because we have like this, I call it airbag, the safety here at 9. We will just lose the difference between both strike prices. So the difference between both strike prices is $1. $1 is the maximum risk, and from this maximum risk, you always have to deduct your premium. The premium here is, as you can see, 37 cents for the moment. So what does it mean? We have a premium of 37 cent. We have a difference of the both strike prices of $1. So you have to deduct this from this $1, and you get like 63 cents as maximum risk. And this is exactly what was shown in the presentation. It's really good to have to know in the beginning what's your maximum reward and what's your maximum risk. So here in this case, we have a risk reward ratio from 1 to 2. We can earn like $1, and we can lose maximum $2, and this is only the worst case scenario, what only happens at the end of the expiration. So normally, if I check all my trades in the past, the maximum risk for a credit spread maybe happened once with 100 trades, because if I see it's going below 9, I can still close the position with a lower risk. But it's a really nice way to make sure that you cannot lose more than what you calculated in the beginning. And this is a brilliant way to do it with this credit spreads, and in both sides. You can do it either with the credit put spreads as credit call spreads. And I know here in this presentation, we have just a small time to present this. But as I already said, in May, we have deeper or longer seminars, which we will present with more detailed with documentation about all these things, because it needs a little bit training, some more information. And as I already told you in the beginning, the chance will still be there. I don't think anything will go back to normal in the next few weeks. So there's still a high chance with a high volatility in the future. And if you want to still be taking your chance in this situation. I think credit spreads for the beginning is, even for smaller portfolios, a really smart way to have this great premium, but with a maximum risk what you can calculate from the beginning. And I can explain the same on the credit call spread. For this, I want to show you what we discussed as a second point in the presentation. It's the ETF. Maybe let's check first the chart for this ETF. You can see it here. This was middle of March, where we really went up to a really high volatile market. Now, the last days, it goes all a little bit down. And I mean, we all don't know, but at the moment, it looks like maybe the second hit is coming soon. We have at least 2 days where the volatility is going up a little bit. And what is really smart, also, if you go back in the past, maybe for this ETF, you don't have this long past what you can see in the chart. But for the index, so check the index, you have like a longer period of time. Let's make it a little bit smaller. You can also check this on different websites. You will always see this is the normal range between like 10 and 17. For this, it will take really long until we see maybe this level again. But what we all seen in 2008 and 2001 with all the really high volatility markets what we had in the past, when it went up, it will always go down. Nobody knows how long it will take to go down on a normal level what we had in the last year. But what we definitely know, if it reaches like peaks, like 80, I think was also 85, the highest value what we had in 2008, the financial crisis. And here's very smart to come back to this topic of credit call spreads. Because in these products, you can you can buy a put option to say it's going down. You can also, if you have the chance, to just short sell the ETF, the ETN itself. But this is something what I will never recommend, because with option, as I said, you know your chance, you know your risk. So it's a bit smarter way. And if we assume, for example, to stay here on this ETF, let's say we had like here the highest price on 80, and nobody thinks that we will have of the end of by the end of the year still some high level of 80. Maybe we will stay here between 30 and 50 or maybe 60. This is a range what maybe you can also see it in the past with other crises. It will go always down from the peaks what we had in the past. And how can you use this now for an option strategy in terms of credit call spreads? We will also go here to our option trader and we will choose really some kind of longer expiration date. Let's really go back to December, for example, what is still quite far away. But to show you an example how we can set up a trade, I will just choose a few strike prices on that high level. So at the moment, it is at $47. So let's say at the end of the year, we assume it will go not higher than $65. So what we can do, we can sell this call option of 65, and just to make sure if it's, I don't know for what reason, will be on a really high level, we will buy a option on $70. You can also do this on a shorter expiration day, but it will exactly be the same model what we had for American Airlines. The difference of these two strike prices is $5, and now we are coming to the maximum risk reward ratio, $5. What we will gain if we open this position, it might be not so fancy because the expiration is quite long. We can set this up maybe for 90 cents. So what we will do, we will deduct this 90 cents from the $5, because then you have your maximum risk, what is $4.10. And if you take this and set it in a ratio to the 90 cents, what's your maximum premium? You will see it's lower than 1 to 4. It's a little bit lower, but this is exactly what makes this position so smart. You can know from the beginning what's your chance risk reward, and you can play this even on 2, 3 weeks options. There's a lot of ways where you can do this, for example. And just to give you another example for the short straddle and strangle, to make it not too complicated, just to the last example what we have here, because that was something what we did when we saw that the volatility is going slightly back to a normal level. What we did, we sold a call and a put option on a $60 basis, $60 basis, and we got such a high premium for this. It was $24 premium. So what does it mean? You take this strike price, and then you have the range strike price plus your premium, what was $24, and strike price minus your premium, then you have exactly your break-even range. And here in this case, it was 84, so almost exactly the highest price. And below it was 36, so we had a perfect range where we are with a high probability that we gain as much as possible. Of course, the highest benefit, the highest profit you will have at the expiration date if it's nearly 60, but these are all smart ways where you can participate of this really high volatility in the index itself, in the ETF itself. And what I just give you here is very short examples. We can really go deeply into it in our upcoming seminars in May, because we will not only use this in a situation what we have now in the moment. At the moment, you can also use this for the future to protect your portfolio, because normally VIX is like you see here on a really low level. As soon as something happens in the market, it will show you or it will give you some benefit to protect your portfolio, because when you have a lot of stock positions, they will all go down and you will have a big open loss. This call options on a VIX index can really help you to protect at least some of your existing portfolio. And at the moment, it's a nice way to play, because with this index and ETFs, you have the chance to both sides to get some extra performance. Because if you look on the chart in the past, as I said, it's some things are really obvious. It's just the idea how to set it up right. And I think credit call spread is one point, but on the other hand side, also if it's on a high level like we had it here, and you see it's slightly going down, a just simple put option can also help you to benefit from a situation like this. So I hope you got some ideas of these short examples. What we had as well was the credit spreads with the risk reward ratio. I think I explained it twice with American Airlines, and now with the ETN on the volatility as well. And maybe we can make another example for some symbol stock. If you would like to see something or interested in a particular stock, you can also use the chat function to tell me any stock, but I want to take maybe one of the financial industry, AMD. Today, one of the bigger losers here in the Nasdaq, 8% minus. It was with $57. Let's say we will play it here a bit far from the price. I want to buy AMD for $40. I can place a limit order here, same as American Airlines. Maybe it will never happen. I will never get this price, so I can wait for the next few weeks. Or if it really goes down and I'm lucky, I get this share or this stock for $40. So what do you think if I check the option for the same period of time for 1 month, how much in percentage will we get from selling a put option on $40? Will we even get anything? Maybe it should be 0 cent or nothing. Let's have a look, and maybe then from the chart you can understand it's really a good chance at the moment to use this. Even if we see it percentage-wise comparing to the actual price. So AMD, we have to select 40. That's also something you will not see all the strike prices normally at the beginning. So you have to select this here in the TWS. We go to 15 of May. So it's far away from being nothing. It's still 74 cents. So let's say if nothing happens, you just have $75 more on your portfolio if it stays above 40. And instead of buying, just setting a limit order, I think this example also explains it very clear. That's an easy way to get some more benefit for your portfolio. So, and then we had some examples from yesterday, what I also showed in the presentation with three different stocks, and we also want to see them and maybe find some way also to use this. One was the financial ETF XXXLF. It's also down with 3% today. We saw a big call option yesterday coming through. On target of 25. So just to show you how you can see this information. I'm not 100% sure if it was 20, because this is also a smart way what you have to know about options, open interest. Because if you are honest, in a stock position, you can check the volume. Of course, now all the stocks have a really high volume, but mostly the volume is also coming from automated trading system, which are buying and selling. Some of them in the high frequency trading sector, they will buy and sell in a couple of seconds. So a volume in the stock itself will not really help you to analyze something, but in options it's something else, because normally call options, somebody is betting on that the stock is going up, or put options going down. But also you can see exactly how much positions are still open, because the open interest will give you an example how much positions are still open in the market. And then you will see like where's the biggest volume, where are the biggest bets for which strike prices. And here we have 23. This is something what we also created, scanning tool, where you can scan all the markets for institutional money, what's going in. We always check every position, what is like higher than 1 million per trade. And then we want to see it's an opening position. Are there some positions are closed? And all this information you can easily analyze here in TradeStation or TWS and in option trading. Because in stocks, with all this high frequency trading and automated trading system, it's not possible to analyze. It needs some more time to understand what possibilities you have in option trading, but I think this is the right time to take the chance if you have the time, of course, to study a little bit more, because as I said, this high volatility environment, we will still see it over the summer at least, and before we go back to really low levels what we had last year, it will really take some more months, maybe we will even take 1 or 2 years to come back to the same level or more than this, but it will not go back so soon. I'm pretty sure about it. So the other one what we had was one stock from healthcare industry. I think I also told you this in one of the previous webinars. You have to check here one really easy website with all the information, what's called finvis.com, and the second symbol what I want to show you is OPK, OPK, some biotech stock what went up a lot in the last few weeks. Since beginning of April, we almost it almost doubled its value. You can see it's stock itself is super high volatility, but it also gives you a great chance to play the same what we did here with the some option strategy. Let's have a look on the chart before we are running out of time. So it's listed exactly at $2, $1.98. And as it already went up the last few days, I would say maybe I would prefer to have it for $1.50 or on a lower price, I don't know. So same model what we had for our last option. Let's see here, you get 20 cents per share, so $20 on an put option on $1.50. So when I really want to buy it like 25% cheaper than the price is now, if it's going down, I mean, if it's not going down, I will not get it anyway. If I place a limit order or if I do have an option, it's both not giving you the stock itself. But it's some really smart way, and 20 cents comparing to the price, yeah. I think I can put it to the calculator, but you will realize this is two digits percentage what we get in a little bit more than 3 weeks, and this is a performance on top of the share what you will have, what's really like a high premium. And if you want to go like a little bit more aggressive in the market and just want to make sure that you really get this stock, you can choose. You can also go to $2. It's giving you 40 cents, at least minimum 40 cents. And if you compare it to the price itself, what's $2? It's much smarter maybe to buy it through a put option instead of just buying it here, because you already earned 40 cents, and 40 cents gives you the break even. It's also a very smart, easy calculation. Your strike price, what was your premium? So your break even is $1.60. So you agree, I mean, if it's going up to $3, of course, then you will not have the big benefit. You will just stay with your 40 cents, what you get as a premium. You will not get a share because it's higher than the $2, than your strike price. But if it stays here, 190, 180, whatever, I will still have this stock in my portfolio. I will get this premium. And I mean, at the moment, I would prefer just to create premiums from selling options if I have some good ideas for stocks like this one. Because as long as I don't have this stock, I'm not in a risk position. If I just collect premium and it's expiring in 3 weeks, then I can do the same with another stock. So there are so many examples at the moment where you can have a really high premium. Of course, you have to investigate what exactly is this company doing. But the last step you should always consider to do it with an option. And this is here, I think, not a bad deal because 100 shares, it's $200. And if you get like $40 on top of it, why not trying it with an option here on OPK? OPK, sorry. I think, yeah, this example, we can make a last one, what we had from yesterday. And also, don't forget this stock here. I mean, it's having its own use, but if you compare it to the whole market condition, we can see it very easily here in Finvis. Today, there's nothing. Maybe we have here two, three big stocks what still are green. The rest is really going down a lot. We have almost everywhere 3% minus, and this stock is still staying on a really good level. So I think this is also some good thing at the moment. If you find a stock what is going in a market condition and not correlated with the whole market down, instead of like staying on the price level what we exactly have here. And this stock already had like a small gap at the beginning. It opened at $10.09 or $10.10, so it was even in profit or in yeah in above the closing price from yesterday, sorry. So yeah, the last one what I brought you from yesterday is a little bit bigger stock also from the market capitalization. It's SQ, where we also found like some high option volume yesterday, and here's exactly the same. If you have a chance to check the option and the option prices, you will find almost everywhere now prices 5-6% for 3-4 weeks expiration. So please make sure if you want to create some long-term portfolio that you of course choose first your stocks itself, and then try to go deeper in this put writing and how to create a portfolio with this selling of put options. And as I said in the beginning, we will follow up in May with a much more deeper and detailed presentation regarding all these topics, and also with like PDF documentation for all the necessary things what you need to know, because I know this is nothing what you will learn in like just 1 hour or with a YouTube video. There needs to be some more detailed documentation. And what we also would like to do is our weekly webinar, where we exactly show you stocks like what we had now here, SQ, or like also OPK, with our option screener with this really high institutional trades, which we can find out for every day in the market. I mean, mainly they are like big positions on Apple and other ETFs, what's on normal, but it's I think really important to have a look between the lines, where we can see other stocks what are not so frequently traded in these high positions. So also for beginners, it might be helpful to attend this weekly webinars with our chat forum, where we explain all the details, different setups, because as you might already seen in this small presentation, we can't benefit only from one side. We are just like discussing short put options or selling of put options, but there are so many other ways with credit spreads, with straddles, with strangles, and to get the benefit of the whole portfolio of option strategies, of course this will take much longer. But for the beginning, I would always recommend to start with like short put, covered call, and credit spreads. And this we will teach you step by step. All this information will be find on our website or also on our YouTube channel. Just for the next week, what I will also recommend for you, our last webinar for April. You will find the dates on the TradeStation calendar, as well as of course on our website itself. It's on the 13th of April, cash versus margin account. What is the benefit? What is the disadvantage if you have a cash account? What you have to be aware of, especially in cash accounts, there are a few things what people, I think, in the beginning might not know, and then they are wondering why this is not tradable, or why I have to wait 1 or 2 weeks before my cash is still available or again available for trading. So we will give you a really detailed overview what you have to check, and then you can also always decide to go back to a cash account, to go back to a margin account. This is something what you can also set up in your client portal. So I think this is for new accounts a very useful topic at the beginning. And what is also the risk to have a margin account? Because I think in the beginning this is something what people don't know, why they choose cash account, and that's why we decided to give you a detailed overview with all the examples what you can do and what you have to be aware of. So thank you for your attention. Our details you find here with phone number, email, and also our website. If you have seen this presentation on our YouTube channel, please feel free and like our video or subscribe to our channel to not miss out anything in the future. And feel free to ask all your questions here. I'm still able to answer this in the next 10 minutes. Just use the chat function on your right-hand side. And I hope to welcome you again in the next week in our next webinar.